a lot for the hetero cross-dressers. I don't know what they would do if they didn't have someone to help push them along, give them some guidance.
So Veronica was essential in making me understand that it's okay to be everything at once. What do you think of Veronica?
I think she's absolutely lovely and a real gift to the city.
You look fabulous.
Philadelphia. It's very nice to look out at all these happy, beaming faces. Nice to see you, sir. Tonight is actually a very special night because today is actually the publication date. So this is kind of a party for Miss Veronica Vera. Cross-dressing for success. I've tried it. It's worked for me. I recommend it to everyone. I've got my lipstick here and I can't wait to put it on. So with no further ado, I shall introduce, ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Veronica Vera.
Thank you. Good evening, class. Now, some of you have lipsticks, and I invite you now to put them on. If you need help, I would hope that some of the ladies would assist the gentlemen. And now, for the really brave and bold one. Tight waist and corset.
I may be too fat for it, but.
Turn this way, let's face everyone.
Not that poochie.
Okay. Now I have to take my glasses.
Oh, look at that.
Wow. Ooh, the corset turns every breath into an orgasm.
Let's see.
Okay. So now I'll let you know a little bit about Miss Vera's Cross-Dress for Success, my new book, which is actually inspired by my school, Miss Vera's Finishing School for Boys Who Want to Be Girls, the world's first cross-dressing academy. Students spend anywhere from a couple of hours with us to a couple of days, immersed in classes with a faculty of deans who teach the men how to do their makeup, walk in high heels, go out and about town on femme, probe their erotic yearnings, network with others, and in general share and appreciate this part of themselves that has inspired them to dress in female clothing, often in secret, since they were children. Many people besides Academy students feel the need to transcend gender. When women felt it, we created the women's movement, and for every woman who burned her bra, there's a man ready to wear one.